Hi guys, I'm really scared today.
Oh, I'm alright.
I'm perfectly whelmed.
Okay, well actually I'm KP.
I'm Andrew.
I'm Sasha.
And I'm still scared because today on NerdDirt, we're going to be talking about horror movies. Ooh. And I'm going to have to edit this. I'm going to get really scared and I'm going to have to edit this during the daytime. Ooh. But hi.
You know, it's traumatic right now.
Yes, I am actually kind of being traumatic. Okay. We are going to be talking about horror movies, past and present.
Okay.
And we're going to be talking about your favorites, not mine, because I don't have a favorite. We're just going to kind of shoot the breeze and be nerdy about it.
Sounds
so what's
good.
What's your guys' like initial about horror movies? Do you like them?
Oh, I love
like
horror movies. Yeah.
That's mostly all I watch.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's nothing better than being on your couch and just watching some shitty horror movie on Netflix. Like,
no, dude.
Plenty of alcohol.
What do you consider shitty?
Here's
like the super campy to where it's ridiculous. So I don't know if you saw The Babysitter on Netflix.
Oh, yeah.
That was amazing. I love that. But like, it's kind of shitty. But yeah. It was awesome. Yeah.
I think a lot of people have a bunch of different ideas of what shitty could be.
Yeah.
Like, I know a lot of people consider like anything that's corny, like that shitty. Like, so a lot of like horror films like from the 80s or like the 70s where you know, like
it's kind of like campy, low budget.
Yeah
like low budget.
So when you say it's like that kind of movie, it's like basically not a bad movie, but just kind of a more low budget. Like what is it with like the low, like I know like before, maybe even now, like they kind of keep it to a lower budget because horror movies make a lot of money, so they want to keep the budget low.
Yeah,
But like what types of horror movies get like the best out of you, I guess? I don't know, like
lately I've been liking the horror movies where there's not a whole lot of scary stuff in most of the movies, just kind of like tension building. And then
like
the
Hereditary.
Very end, Hereditary, that's what I was thinking of, and also Midsommar.
Midsommar was
the same
perfect.
I saw it three times in theaters.
It was
great. It was like awesome.
Yeah. Creepy AF, the trailer was like, everything's in the daytime, but I'm still creeped out. And I'm like,
and that's part of it, is that like, they're in, I think it's Sweden, right? Is it Sweden?
Yes.
Yeah, and it's like, the sun doesn't even set there until 9, then it's only down for like 3 or 4 hours.
So oh,
basically the entire movie's in the day, but it's still super creepy and scary.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, because it plays on, like, how sick people can be.
Yeah.
Or, I don't want to say sick, because we don't want to piss anyone off.
Right.
But...
wow.
But it's more so, like, playing off of, like, how different and culture... Like, how, like, different other cultures are, and, like, playing into, like, culture shock, and just, like, not really understanding of an environment that you're in.
Yeah.
The thing that I really liked about Midsommar was that... It showed how somebody can get brought into a culture very easily.
Yeah.
Like, whether it's, like, trauma that leads you there in your life, or, like, just assimilating better to those people, like, in general. I thought that was really interesting about Midsommar. So it shows, like, the whole phase of, like, somebody just being immersed into a world and, like, accepting it as, like, this is what I want to do for the rest of my life.
And another thing I liked about Midsommar is usually movies like that where they're, like, go somewhere and it's just, like... a different culture and it's creepy. Usually it's more like indigenous cultures where they go and it's like, what was that movie like? Is it
Cannibal Holocaust?
Yeah, Cannibal Holocaust or something like that. But this is just white people. It's like, like they didn't try.
They be scary.
Yeah, it wasn't like that kind of racist vibe of like, oh, like brown people are like, not civilized or something. And then in this one, it's like, they're civilized, but they're still weird as fuck.
There's, I think that's very interesting that you brought that up, because, like, me and my boyfriend talk about this all the time, because both of us are horror fanatics, and, like, I love to bring up about how, like, the whole idea of, like brown people's indigenous, like, ancient culture is scary, and you should be afraid, and there's, like, a lot of underlying racism in it to me, and my boyfriend's like, can we just watch the movie? Like,
things we don't understand are scary, guys.
Yeah.
Okay, so again, recently, did you see the new It that just came out?
Yeah.
Not too recently.
Oh, I was going to ask about that because.
How did you feel about that?
I loved it. I thought it was a great film. I thought there was a lot of things that I'm like, this is kind of like there's holes or it can be improved. But like overall, I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it.
I got bored.
Really?
I got bored.
Oh,
the
weird.
Whole middle segment where it's just like they're flashing back to when they were kids, but it doesn't work after a while because like you know they don't die when they're kids, so there's nothing really scary about
the flashbacks. Yeah, it's not like you're gonna go to the present and one of them's missing right. already. Yeah, it's like, no, they survived. Yeah. We know they survived.
Like, and then it's very like, it follows a formula where he shows up and then he has every opportunity to kill them and then just doesn't. Yeah. For whatever reason, like, these are the chosen ones that aren't allowed to be killed until the very end. Mm-hmm. But,
oh, spoiler alert.
And then... and then there was that scene which really threw me off where it's, I think it was... Was it Richie? Is that the character's name?
Are we getting into spoilers? Because
it's not spoilers. Okay. It's just, like... It's, like, it's a scary thing with him, and then it's, like, the mood set and everything, and they play this, like, cheesy 80s song. It's, like... I can't remember the name of it. But okay. It's just, like... Literally, this campy 80s song that comes on in the middle of it and just completely ruins the mood of it being, like, a scary moment. Mm. And I was like, alright, I'm kind of out of it.
Yeah, no. it's strange because what's funny about the new It was there was a lot of comedic relief to it. There was a lot of comedic relief. And I think, like, that's something that I'm seeing a lot in movies. Like, in the horror movies overall, there's a lot of comedic relief.
Yeah, horror's always been very close to, like, comedy. Yeah. There's always been some comedic element to... Like every
it just takes a little bit to changing into a comedy.
Exactly.
Like, I remember growing up with that, like, because there'd be, like, horror Filipino movies, like, when I was a little kid, that my parents would watch, and they're just like, oh, this is a horror film, you can't watch it. But I'm looking at it, it's like, it's corny AF, and how come, like, everything's so lit up so much? I was like, I can see
it,
everything.
Was it, like, a haunted slipper?
No, like, it's just, like, it's like, it's the same horror, but I think, like, and we're kind of getting into this subject as well, too, because I kind of want you guys to talk about it.
Yeah.
But the reason it wasn't horrific for me, like, it wasn't as horrifying as, like some, like, the 80s, 90s, even 70s campy films.
Yeah.
Is because I saw everything. Because, like, the whole set is like, there's a dozen lights. So I was like, I can see the ghost waiting in the closet.
Yeah.
So I know it's gonna come out. So it's like, that's why it wasn't scary.
Yeah.
Whereas, and I feel like I wanted to ask you guys this question.
Yeah.
Like, other, like, films in the 70s and 80s that I would, like, watch, like, 5 minutes in and get too scared when I was a little kid.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, those were a lot more scary. And I wanted to ask this question. What, in your guys' opinion, makes a good, scary, good horror film? And if you have an example, that would be even better as well, too. Maybe one of your favorites.
Yeah. I think what makes, like, a good horror film overall is when you have a moment that lasts forever in your mind.
Yes.
Like something that just, you, like, even a week later, you're still thinking about it, you know? Like, something that, like, resonates with you and stays with you.
Yeah.
A big plight that I have, like, for current horror is it's very jump scare heavy. Like, it's always constantly relying on the boo, and then it's just like, okay, like, we're over that moment. Yeah, like, let's keep it rolling, you know? But now, like... Something that I really liked as of recent, like, Us is now one of my favorite horror films. And I think, like, a moment that really, like, shook me because, like, it was very subtle was when her tethered is explaining how she had a C-section for one of her kids. You know, she was explaining how, like, oh, you know, she was in a nice hospital and everything, and the other girl just, like, basically had a C-section performed on her. You don't understand the extent of how, like, just there was no anesthetics, there was no proper tools being used, like, because in the tethered world, when you see it, it's, like, it's just them mimicking what it would be like if it was on our regular realm, and, like, when you're seeing that, you think, like, oh my god, they just straight up ripped this girl open and took her baby.
Yeah.
Like, and you're like, oh my god, like, that stayed with me. It's still with me, like, right now. So it's, like, something, like, where it's, like, they didn't have to show it.
It's like,
look at it.
I wasn't even pregnant, they just cut me.
She was mimicking the pregnancy. Yeah, no, it was just, what I really, like, liked about that movie was, like, they didn't even have to show that part. Like, they just, it was implied when you got a glimpse of, like, the tethered world. It was like, oh, she really got messed up, like, when that was happening. But they didn't even have to show it. Like, and I thought, like, that was really cool. So things like that stay with me. Like,
I think, like, when your imagination is more sparked than actually showing it to you, that's the stuff that, like, like, that's the stuff that usually scares me a lot, too. It's just like, remember this thing that happened? And you're like, what thing? I think it goes back to even, like, when you had, like, when you're a kid and you had, like, those, like, superstitions, like the Bloody Marys and stuff. Yeah, and it's like, they just tell you what happened, but you didn't have to see it. But at the same time, you also just, like, but you had to live with it because every time you're in the bathroom alone, you're just like, should I go to the bathroom and do it now? Like, but it's then, like, the bathroom, just going to the bathroom becomes, like, the scariest thing.
Right.
So,
Very similar. like you said, like the jump scares, they're cool, but they don't really stick with me. They're just kind of, it's an in the moment thing. The things are like, it just like gets a character so down that it just hits you on a deep, deep level. Like my, one of my favorites is The Descent, but the UK version of The Descent.
Oh, wow.
I heard about
so
that one.
That's, so I'm gonna just spoil this because it's an old enough movie. Like y'all should
watch it. This is the spoiler episode.
Yes. So they go down into this cave, like spelunking, I think is the term for it. Mm. And then they get caught by these monsters, this whole big thing, like one by one, they're kind of picked off. And the main girl, she makes it out, or so you think. And then it flashes back to earlier when she had fell down and hit her head. And then she wakes up. And then you just hear all the monsters like coming in, like closing in on her. And you realize like, she's fucked.
Yeah.
And so just like gets your hopes up for a second that like, there's that light at the end of the tunnel and she's gonna be okay and someone survived. And then no, it's it was brutal. That stuck with me for a long time.
Yeah. And you even have to see the monsters actually get her. It's just like, just the knowledge.
Yeah, just like you hear like the scraping and you kind of see the silhouettes of them kind of approaching her, and you're like, all
right.
It's
subtle. Yeah. It's very subtle, but like because of the whole setup of the movie, you just know the severity of the situation. Yep. Now it's scary. Because
You've seen plenty of brutal shit before this, so you know what you're capable of. So you're like, she's gonna get her.
Right.
Hey, that was weird. Why did I fucking do that? Hey, just watch Three Sweet Don't Cheat, so you can watch us play board games, which I mostly win because I be editing the show, and I only put on the stuff that I win. It makes me feel better about myself. So, watch that journey on Three Sweet Don't Cheat.